Hey friends, welcome to the YouTube channel All About Electronics. So in this video we will see what is resonance in the series RLC circuit, or simply a series resonance in the RLC circuit. So first of all, intuitively we will understand what do we mean by this resonance in this series RLC circuit, and we will see the related parameters to this series RLC circuit, and then after mathematically we will derive all the expressions related to this series RLC circuit. So first of all, let us understand what is resonance in the electrical circuit. So in electrical circuit, resonance is nothing but a phenomenon at which the response of the circuit is maximum for a given particular frequency. So let us say we have one circuit which contains a resistor, inductor and a capacitor. Now let us assume that to this circuit we have applied some AC voltage source of a particular frequency, and also assume that this voltage source is tunable. Now for the given frequency, at the output we will get some response. Now as we tune this voltage source particular frequency, it will happen that the response of the circuit will be the maximum. So this phenomenon is known as the resonance in the electrical circuit, and that particular frequency at which we are getting the maximum output is known as the resonant frequency. Now this resonance phenomenon we are seeing in the electrical circuit because of the capacitor and the inductor, as both the elements have ability to store the energy. So now let us understand this resonance phenomena by taking simple LC circuit. So let us say we have one LC circuit, and in this LC circuit we have applied some voltage source, and at time t is equal to 0 we are removing this voltage source and replacing it with a short circuit. So as we know, the inductor and capacitor have ability to store the energy. So even if we remove this voltage source, the inductor will continue to supply a current to this capacitor, and through that current the capacitor will get charged, and later on this capacitor will act as a voltage source and it will again supply energy back to the inductor. So in this way the energy will get transferred between the inductor and the capacitor, and the rate of transfer of this energy depends upon the value of this L and C, and because of this transfer of energy we will see the oscillation in our circuit. So now if the circuit is ideal and do not have any resistance involved, then this oscillation will continue forever. But all the circuits have some resistance involved in the circuit. So because of that resistance, the energy will get dissipated across that resistor, and eventually this oscillation will die out. So to maintain this oscillation, we need to supply some external source with the same frequency to this LC circuit so that the oscillation will continue forever. So now we know that this capacitor and inductor have a tendency to produce the oscillation in the circuit, while this resistor have a tendency to reduce these oscillations. So now let us see the resonance condition in the series RLC circuit. So now let us say in this circuit we have applied a AC voltage source which is having a value of V0 into sine omega t, and because of this voltage source we are getting some current through this circuit. So now as we change the frequency of this voltage source, then at particular one frequency we will get a maximum current that is flowing through this circuit, and that is known as the resonant condition. So if we see graphically this phenomena, it will look like this. At lower frequency there will not be any current that is flowing through the circuit, and also at higher frequency if you see, there will not be any current that is flowing through the circuit. So as we move towards the resonant frequency, you will see that the current that is flowing through the circuit will suddenly increase, and at resonant frequency you will find a maximum current that is flowing through the circuit, and again as we move away from this resonant frequency, again the current will fall down, and eventually at higher frequencies this current will go to the zero. Now we know that the XL can be given as omega into L, and XC can be given as 1 over omega C. So at omega is equal to 0, if you see, this XC term will be infinity and XL will be 0. So in this circuit, this capacitor will act as a open circuit, and hence you will not find any current. Similarly, at omega is equal to infinity, if you see, this XL term will be infinity. So again, at higher frequencies this inductor will act as a open circuit, and again you will not find any current that is flowing through the circuit. So that is the reason at lower and higher frequencies the current that is flowing through the circuit is minimum, while at resonant frequency the value of XL that is equal to XC, and hence the impedance of the circuit is purely resistive, where you find the maximum current that is flowing through the circuit. We will see more about it when we'll derive all the expressions related to this RLC circuit. So now this RLC circuit basically provides us some kind of selectivity for the given particular frequency. And this principle is used in a radio communication for selecting a particular channel. Let us say you have a FM receiver and you want to tune your FM receiver at one particular frequency or one particular channel. So now let us say we want to change our channel. So what we used to do, we used to change the knob in the receiver. So eventually what we are doing, we are changing the capacitor value of in the circuit. So if we change the value of this capacitor, then this curve will get shifted to some another frequency, let's say omega R2. And in this way, we are able to change the channel or a frequency of the given receiver. So this principle is used mainly in a radio communication for selecting a particular channel. So now for the good selectivity, the resonant curve should be as narrower as possible so that you will not find any interference from the another circuit. And to achieve this, the value of the resistance in the circuit should be as low as possible. So here, as you can see, we have a three different resonant curve for the different values of the resistor. As the value of resistance increases, the curve is getting wider and wider. And as the value of resistance decreases, the curve is also getting narrower. So for a good selectivity of a channel, the value of resistance should be as low as possible in the circuit. Also at lower resistance, you will see that the peak current that we are getting is also maximum. So as the value of resistance reduces, the current that you get at resonant frequency will also increases. So to define this sharpness of the curve or the selectivity of the circuit, the two parameters are widely used for the resonance circuit, that are quality factor and a bandwidth. So let us see them one by one. So now first of all, let us talk about the quality factor. So this quality factor is defined as 2 pi into maximum amount of energy that is stored across the element in the circuit divided by the energy that is dissipated across the resistor. So as we already know, as the value of resistance in the circuit increases, the circuit will have a less tendency to oscillate. And because of that, if you see the resonant curve, it will also get wider. So basically this quality factor defines the sharpness of this resonant curve, or simply it defines the selectivity of the series RLC circuit. So we will derive the expression for this quality factor in terms of this resistor, capacitor and inductor at the later part. Similarly, now let us see about the bandwidth. So now this bandwidth is defined as the difference between the minus 3 dB frequencies in the given circuit, or it is also defined as the difference between the half power frequencies. Now let us first of all understand what do we mean by this minus 3 dB frequencies or a half power frequencies. So this half power frequencies is nothing but the frequencies at which the power of the circuit is getting reduced to the half. Or if you see the current, in terms of the current, the value of current is getting reduced to the 1 by root 2 of the maximum value. So this F1 is known as the lower cutoff frequency and this F2 is known as the upper cutoff frequency. So difference between this F2 minus F1 is known as the bandwidth. Or if we talk about in terms of the angular frequency, then the difference between omega 2 minus omega 1 defines the bandwidth of the circuit. So for the good selectivity, the bandwidth of the circuit should be as narrower as possible. So we will also derive this bandwidth in terms of the resistor, capacitor and the inductor of the given circuit. So far we have intuitively seen that what do we mean by the resonance in the electrical circuit and what are the different parameters related to this series resonant circuit. So now let us derive the mathematical expressions for this series resonant circuit. So let us once again assume that we have applied a voltage V is equal to V0 into sine omega t into the series RLC circuit, and because of that current I is flowing in the circuit. So now this current I can be defined as a V over the impedance Z, where Z is nothing but a R plus XL plus XC, that is a series combination of R plus XL plus XC, where XL is nothing but J into omega L and XC is nothing but minus J over omega C. So we can write it as a R plus J into omega L minus 1 over omega C. So that is how we can define the impedance of the circuit. So we know that at resonant frequency we are getting the maximum amount of current. So to get a maximum amount of the value of impedance should be minimum. And this minimum value of impedance is possible when this term is 0. That means when omega L minus 1 over omega C is 0, then we will get a minimum value of impedance. And the value of impedance will be nothing but a R. So this is known as the resonant condition. That means when XL is equal to XC or omega L is equal to 1 over omega C, then you will get a minimum amount of impedance in the circuit, and hence the maximum amount of current will flow through the circuit, and that maximum current can be defined as V over R. Now we can write this omega L over 1 over omega C as omega square, that is equal to 1 over LC, or we can say that omega is nothing but 1 over under root LC. So this frequency is known as the resonant frequency of the circuit. So if we write it in terms of the frequency, then we can write it as a F over 1 over 2 pi into under root LC. So this frequency is known as the resonant frequency for the given circuit. So now let us derive the expression for the bandwidth in terms of the R, L and C. So as we have seen so far, this F1 and F2 are the upper and the lower cutoff frequencies respectively, and at those frequencies the value of current will be nothing but a 1 over root 2 of the maximum value. So now we can say that at frequency omega 1, the, let us say the current that is flowing in the circuit is I1, and which can be defined as Imax over root 2. Now this current I1 can be defined as V over under root R square plus omega 1 L minus 1 over omega 1 C whole square. Now squaring up at both the sides, we will get I1 square, that is equal to V square over R square plus omega 1 L minus omega 1 C whole square, that is equal to Imax square by 2, which is nothing but a V square divided by 2R. So now if we compare these two terms, then we can write it as a R square, that is equal to omega 1 L minus 1 over omega 1 C whole square, or we can say that omega 1 L minus 1 over omega 1 C, that is equal to plus or minus R, which is the expression that we got at frequency omega 1. Similarly, we can get another expression for the frequency omega 2 as omega 2 L minus 1 over omega 2 C, that is equal to plus or minus R, which is the expression at frequency omega 2. Now this omega 1 is less than omega R, that is this frequency is less than resonant frequency, and this frequency omega 2 is greater than the omega R. That means this omega 2 is greater than the resonant frequency. So for the frequencies which are lesser than the resonant frequency, if you see, the circuit will have a capacitive reactance because this XC is given as 1 over omega C, and this term will be dominant over this omega 1 L. So the value of omega 1 L minus over omega 1 C will be negative because this term is greater than this omega 1 L. Similarly, the frequencies which are greater than the resonant frequencies, at higher frequencies, if you see, this inductive term will be the dominant. So this omega 2 L term will be greater than omega 2 C term. And because of that, if you see, this omega 2 L minus 1 over omega 2 C term will be the positive. So in this way, we got two different equations for the upper and the lower cutoff frequencies. So let us simplify these two equations. So if we simplify this equation, then we will get omega 1 square into LC minus 1, that is equal to minus R into omega 1 C. And if we simplify it, then we will get omega 1 square plus R by L into omega 1 minus 1 over LC, that is equal to 0. And if we simplify it, then we will get a 2 root of this equation, that is omega 1, that is equal to minus R over 2L plus or minus under root R over 2L whole square plus 1 over LC. Now the frequencies cannot be a negative, so we will not consider the negative root. So we will get omega 1 as minus R over 2L plus under root R over 2L whole square plus 1 over LC. And similarly, we can derive the expressions omega 2 as R over 2L plus under root R over 2L whole square plus 1 over LC. Now the bandwidth can be defined as the difference between this upper and the lower cutoff frequencies. So if we subtract these two equations, then we will get R over 2L minus R over 2L, that is equal to nothing but R over L. So we can define the bandwidth as nothing but R over L. So now let us multiply this omega 1 and omega 2. So if we multiply these two equations, then we can get omega 1 into omega 2 as R over 2L whole square plus 1 over LC minus R over 2L whole square. So in short, we will get omega 1 into omega 2 as 1 over LC, which is nothing but a omega square, that is a square of the resonant frequency. So in this way, we'll get omega R whole square, that is equal to omega 1 into omega 2. So this is the relation between the resonant frequency and the upper and the lower cutoff frequencies. So now let us derive the expression for this quality factor in terms of the circuit components. So as we have discussed earlier, this quality factor is defined as the 2 pi into maximum amount of energy that is stored across the element over the energy that is dissipated across the resistor. And this quality factor is defined as the Q. So this Q is nothing but a energy that is stored across the either inductor or capacitor divided by the energy that is dissipated across the resistor. So we can say that I square into XL over I square into R, or simply we can write it as a XL over R. Now at resonant frequency, this XL is equal to XC. So we can also write it as a XC over R. Now we know that the XL is nothing but omega L over R, where omega is the resonant frequency. So we can also write it as a 1 over omega C over R. So this is the equation of quality factor in terms of the circuit components. So now we know that at resonant frequency, this omega R can be defined as 1 over under root LC. So we can write this equation as 1 over R under root L by C. So this is the equation of the quality factor in terms of the circuit components. Now if you see here, this R by L is nothing but a bandwidth of the circuit. So we can also write this quality factor Q as omega over bandwidth, or omega R over bandwidth, where omega R is the resonant frequency and this R by L is nothing but a bandwidth of the circuit. So in this way, we can write this quality factor as 1 over R under root L over C, and also in terms of the bandwidth, we can write it as a omega R over bandwidth of the circuit. So in summary, if you see, these are the equations that we got for the series resonant circuit. So I hope in this video you understood what do we mean by the resonance in the series RLC circuit, and what are the different parameters which are related to this series RLC circuit, like quality factor and the bandwidth. So now in the next video, we will see the resonance for the parallel RLC circuit. So if you have any question or suggestion, please let me know in the comment section below. If you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe to the channel for more such videos.